executive director here at YMA, and welcome to our final performance of Session 2. Thank you for being here. It has been an absolute pleasure to be here this summer and watching these campers grow, and I'm so excited that you get to see this final performance. We would not be able to do it without the support of our board, our faculty, our admin team, and all of you. In addition to the foundation support we get, all of the individual donations we receive go right back into YMA, into our robust financial aid program, making sure that everyone can access this amazing opportunity. If you are feeling generous, there is a QR code on the back of your program. Feel free to make a donation today. A few quick announcements. Please silence your cell phones, put them on airplane mode, no flash photography. And if you absolutely have to get up and exit the theater, please wait till a break between the pieces. It's for your safety and the safety of everybody around you. Thank you, and I hope you enjoy the show.
Thank you. Alternate names for sparks. One, snarky, sarcastic, dry. Two, lost in thoughts. Three, a wall. Four, a quarter of the year. Five, what's left over. Six, rainy days and cold weather. Seven, lost in big groups. Eight, found in friends. Nine, wild hair and crooked teeth turn straight over the years. 10, red dye bleeds to blue, bleeds to purple, bleeds to black. 11, blurry world view without my second pair of eyes. 12, an open book with crossed out pages. 13, a colorful heart dressed in morning colors. 14, blankets covered in the smell of dog. 15, birthmark given by a friend. 16, twin sister, 20 months apart. 17, 17 and still unsure.
Alternate names for whoever I'm supposed to become. One, sister, oldest of four, a quarter of a whole. Two, my mother's daughter, spoken with both love and hate. Three, titles I was proud of, at least before I knew what they meant. Four, nicknames given when little ones couldn't quite say my name. Five, names used to put me down. Six, rice age. my mother's reminder of the name she gave me and the strength it holds. 7, jeers and laughs in the schoolyard when I would explode with pent-up rage that they would just never understand. 8, supernova, stardust, sunshine, reminders of you and how much you love me. 9, Parker, an inside joke that she took to the grave, and so I will too. 10, a connection between lost and found again friends. 11, Bug, for I will always be my mom's little girl no matter how old I get. 12, an endless list of inside jokes, collections of those who love me. I've been called many things over the years, from slurs to pet names, teasing and loving variations of my name, all versions of who I am, a tapestry of thread, knots and stitches made from all I have lost and all I have loved. All these names, all these titles. By the end of the page, they're all just me.
Slideshow. Over the course of the last 2 weeks, the photography students have been working on a lot of projects, both collaborative and individual, and they put together a zine to show you tonight.
The zines are comprised of photos that they feel best express their voices and styles as artists, I think they're all really proud of them, and they're going to tell you a little bit about their zine and how photography has affected their lives.
Hi, my name is Parker, and for me, photography allows me to really find myself and express myself through the images I find and the images I make. And my zine was about finding myself and figuring out who I am and my place in the world.
Hi, I'm Spencer. Photography to me is all about expressing myself without using words.
Hi, I'm Lucas. And what photography means to me is to take a picture of something that makes me feel happy.
Hi, I'm Ruby, and for me, photography is a way to express myself.
I'm Moon, and photography to me is expressing emotion through my photos.
I'm Miley, and photography to me is just a fun way to make art.
I'm Sadie, and photography to me is a visual way to make up for the lack of music.
I'm Lily. Photography to me is expressing myself and creating peace for myself.
I'm Ivy, and photography to me is finding the perfect moment and making art out of it.
Hi, I'm Henry. For me, photography is a way of kind of silencing my ADHD and being able to focus. And it's also a way of preserving a moment in time for the world to see.
Hi, I'm Elise, and for me, photography is seeing something through a new perspective and capturing a moment in time, and that's kind of what I did in my zine, but through people.
I'm Clara, and for me, photography is seeing the world in a different way.
I'm Gina,
and for me, photography is seeing the world. I'm Bridget, and for me, photography is a way to share my experience with others in a visual way.
Hi, my name is Aaron, and I've always loved photography, and this camp has given me an opportunity to take photos every day, and for me, photography is about capturing a moment that you may not see in your everyday life if you're too busy to look around.
Hi, I'm Oliver, and I really just like turning all the settings to the maximum.
Thank you.
great success.
Hi, YMA.
Hi,
YMA. How's everyone doing tonight? I wrote this song about someone that I think should care about themselves more and should think about the world and what it means to them.
The stars in the sky, the old world passing by. It's a home of my own, built for you and me. If only you could see what you mean to me. Perfect just the way you are, perfect just for me. Open your eyes, see yourself for who you are, touch the skies, reach new heights. Open your eyes.
Check student view 92. 3, good job kiddo. 4, daydreaming during class. 5, I stomp stomp clap stomp stomp. 6, is grass your favorite meal? 7, are you Allie's little sister? 8, she's always smiling. 9, you should make more cookies. 10, 5 more minutes please. 11, can I pet your dog? 12, I'm about to lose my Duolingo streak. 13, little bean. 14, let me finish this page. 15, calloused fingertips. 16, best friend since preschool. 17, runs outside to catch a sunset.
Hello, my name is Len or Nuts, and this is alternate names for trans witch boys. 1, absurd humor out of thin air. 2, a mother's son. 3, a father's little girl. 4, snake's playful flick of a tongue. 5, the best gothic horror novella you'll ever read. 6, breath caught at the mention of my kindest influence's name. 7, ever-growing list of fun facts. 8, passionate. 9, provocative. 10, flame of a candle. 11, unique and creative. 12, attention seeker. 13, disrespectful. 14, devil worshiper. 15, a collection of crystals and trinkets. 16, the name long gone, sung in full. 17, angled inconsistencies of a pen's outline. 18, a rebel who tries to be understanding.
I'm Nautilus, and this is alternate names for a young gay boy. 1, the standout child. 2, stalling in front of a locker room door. 3, sun loved like a dog. 4, a burden of change. 5, mom's the scariest child. 6, 17 going on 12. 7, poor little boy. 8, baggy hoodies and basketball shorts. 9, wanting to be known for me and not for who I love. 10, running a mile-long marathon. 11, right time, wrong place. 12, tears and hair on a bathroom sink. 13, a shade of blue that looks too purple. 14, an old name that's never really forgotten. 15, is this what's wrong with me, or is this just me? 16, it'll never be right. 17, one more year to go.
I'm Emerson. This is alternate names for soon to be optimists. 1, fanfiction doesn't make friends. 2, 70 degrees an hour after rain, paradise. 3, romance reader. 4, word weaver. 5, red, blue, and purple family. 6, projecting monologues to the stars. 7, scabs blooming. 8, cotton candy fingers. 9, late night candlelighter. 10, 1942 typewriter keys clacking wildly. 11, shh. 12, hotel Bible reader. 13, birthdays. 14, letters forwarded to the trash can. 15, sweet toothed. 16, crayon collector, cool sock collector. 17, Eeyore enthusiast.
Describe all of the trepidations, dream out of the treasure.
Hey, Cam, it's you there. This is a song I wrote called Someday. The only note I wrote in there is, but it has something to do about optimism in all the gloom. I don't know how to describe it. All I want to say is, if you say and not sing the lyrics of the chorus, you're gonna think of that one monster commercial. Here we go. There's aggression everywhere. This is dystopian. According to all the people, it's all empty now except for me and 20. We're striving now a ghost town. They're all gone now, they're all gone now, they're all gone now, they're all gone now. But someday, someday, someday there'll be restoration, and I'll have my satisfaction. And someday, someday, someday all generations have a great reunion. We're forgotten by everyone, that's a fault of the neglect. Abandonment they will regret. Phoenix that will always rise above, despite all the crows and released us. They're all gone now, they're all gone now, they're all gone now, they're all gone now. But someday, someday, someday there'll be restoration, and I'll have my stats. And someday, someday, someday all generations will have a great reunion. And I'll have my satisfaction. And someday, someday, someday all generations will have a great reunion.
Alternative names for Gwendolyn. 1. Creative writer. 2. Leaf stepper honor. 3. Animal lover. 4. Inhaler of petrichor. 5. Lover of sunsets and cloud shapes. 6. Scare. 7. In between consciousness and sleep. 8. Romance loaf reader. 9. Always dehydrated. 10. Poet. 11. Candy corn enthusiast. 12. Wait, you're a lesbian? 13. Spiders are my friends. 14. I miss my dog. 15. Thesaurus reader. 16. Sleepy. 17. Portlander.
I'm Theo, and this is my poem called Alternative Name for Overthinkers. 1. 428-24. 2. Held responsibility for the two of us. 3. Doing everything I could but still failing. 4. Overthinking. 5. Amnesia of talent. 6. Scribbled out eyes, a stark contrast to white paper. 7. 7 years. 8. One paragraph. 9. Not gone but see through. 10. Tired thoughts. 11. Have a good life. 12. Remember when I skipped class because you guys were there? 13. I waited 4 days. 14. Stuck in my head. 15. I would say them, but then I would have to talk to you. 16. I'm sorry. 17. I still care, but you don't. Did you ever care?
And I'm going to do a poem called Alternate Names for Someone Not from the City. 1. Forest Loving. 2. Salman. 3. Tired but awake. 4. One step forward, two steps back. 5. Her favorite. 6. Hard to look at eyes. 7. Tiny town, tinier friend group. 8. Always changing. 9. Sammy. 10. Water lover. 11. Too afraid to stop it. 12. Turn to bed night.
Alternate names for shy girls. 1. Always stuck in a book. 2. She's pretty quiet, isn't she? 3. Built for rainy days spent inside. 4. Watches watercolor sunsets blotted with fluffy clouds from her bedroom window. 5. Daydreaming through class. 6. Afraid to wear and do what she wants. 7. Spends her days wishing things would change. 8. The world feels too slow. 9. Time flies by too fast. 10. Is she still the little bear? 11. Wears makeup like a mask to hide behind. 12. Does anyone really like her? 13. Does she even like herself? 14. Hide behind glasses, watching the world through thick panes of glass. 15. Scared of being asked questions. 16. Bookstores bring comfort. 17. Does anybody ever see her without a book? 18. Did she get that bone-deep exhaustion too early? 19. Should she feel this tired of life? 20. She sits, simply watching time go by.
From the center section, can I get a book that you've read?
Harry Potter.
Right? The
pretty good. This is all your parents. Readers. Love it. From over here, can I get the best food in Gowdy?
Mashed
potatoes. Lasagna.
Lasagna. Thank you, Henry. Okay, from anywhere in the room, can I get your social security number? Oh, that's a weird social security number. Just straight in a row, 1, 2, 3. Okay, you get it. Great, good job. Your second job is to make sure that when you shout those things, thank you so much, Ghost Egg, wow. Is that you're gonna hoot and holler and support and laugh, especially when you hear the phrase, to the stage, because that means we're calling the improvisers up and you wanna make sure you get them hyped. Improvisers actually feed off of screams. So let's practice that right now. Let's get Nicole McCarty to the stage. The IRS to the stage. Less applause than for Nicole. That's good. Okay, here we go. I think that's it. Oh, there is one more very important thing. Here at YMA, we have a thing called the YMA way, which means that we keep it squeaky clean. So should an offending player or audience member say something rude, crude, lascivious, rotten, nasty, or just plain offensive to me, they will have to wear a brown paper sack over their head for the remainder of that scene. This is a punishment. It is not a privilege. Why am I away? All right. Ghost Egg, we ready?
Yeah!
Audience, you ready?
Yeah!
Go forward, I can make them go backward. There you go. I need a suggestion. Let's go from the center section. What's a place where there are a lot of people doing a lot of things?
Airport!
Ooh, I'm gonna go ahead, I'm gonna take airport. I heard airport nice and loud. Go ahead and move down, Ghost Egg. Move down. All right, here we go. Players, are you ready for your game of forward reverse?
Yeah!
Begin!
It's a lot of work being a plane man!
I fly!
Reverse!
It's a lot of work being a plain man!
Forward!
It's a lot of work being a plain man! You just fly and fly and fly!
Reverse!
You just fly and fly and fly!
Reverse? Oh wait, forward?
You just fly and fly and fly! And fly and fly!
Performing crew over here.
Alien
great, perfect, thank you. Alien abduction. I love rotating. Rotate right. Can I get from the center section something that's about this big?
Handgun.
Purse. Handgun. We're gonna take the purse. Rotate right. Can I get from this section? What's an object you use every day?
Toothbrush.
Lots of people love their toothbrush. Let's keep going.
Shirt.
Oh, good. Good for you. Underwear person, good for you. Pencil is your suggestion, rotate right. From the center section, can I get a period of history?
1907.
Ah, yes. Shakespeare, beat your heart out. The Renaissance, rotate right. All right, here we go. They're going to reiterate suggestion for you?
Alien abduction.
Rotate right.
Purse.
Rotate right. Rotate right.
The Renaissance.
Rotate right. Players, are you ready for your game of Foursquare? And begin.
Look, these cows, man, they're just not telling us much anymore. I've been drawing a lot in the ground, too, and like the crops, and they just don't seem
Hold
to
on.
Care.
Give me a second, I have a plan.
No!
Nothing.
Rotate right.
Look, I know it's your purse, but it like goes with my outfit so well.
You can have a different one. I was gonna wear that one today.
Mom, let me have something.
Anything.
Rotate right.
I broke the pencil you gave me. Shoot. Where do you get these from?
Space.
Rotate right.
Well, I do say that new play was incredible, don't you think?
I think it was good. I still have no idea who the Shakespeare guy is.
Rotate right.
Okay, we have 13 cows, and they all want to go home.
We shouldn't have made the translator. This made things worse.
Yeah, they keep asking me for hay. What's hay? Please, someone tell me what's hay.
Rotate left.
No, I wonder if it's considered a pen name, perchance?
Yeah.
It dragged a little bit, if I'm being honest. Towards the end, I mean, a lot of debt, not much else.
Yeah. Rotate left!
Okay. But what do you mean by space?
Outer space.
Rotate left! To the soundproof street, because we're gonna need to get some suggestions from all of you for this next game. So, from like the front couple of rows, can you give me a piece of advice that someone's actually given you?
Be kind.
Be kind, thank you. Wow, that's good advice, be kind. Awesome, can we get some more?
Take a nap.
Not your section, but I appreciate the power.
Cover your mouth when you cough.
Cover your mouth when you cough.
Got it.
Awesome. From the back section, can I get some song lyrics?
This is a song that never ends.
Thank you. This is the song that never ends. Awesome. Awesome. From the back, some more? Oh, I love that you're singing. That's amazing. I can't tell what you're saying because you're singing. Over here, can I get a slogan for a large multinational corporation?
Just do it!
Wonderful. Just do it, please. Oregon, represent. Can I get a stage direction, something someone can do on stage?
Up
there. Run.
Right.
Not your section, but thank you.
Go stage.
Right.
Down stage.
Do a flip. Find your
life. Do a backflip. All right, is that six? Perfect, awesome, okay, good. So what's gonna happen in this game is we're gonna bring our improvisers back in. They're not gonna know what we've written down on these lines. When they lose the plot or the thread, they're gonna reach down, they're gonna grab a line, they're gonna read it verbatim. Everybody go, ooh. Yeah. All right, let's welcome them back in by chanting, come back, come back. Ready for your game of Bloodline?
Yes.
And begin.
Boys don't cry.
No, do not either.
Don't cry.
Yes, they do.
No, they don't. Not if you're a real man.
Don't
cry.
You're not a real man.
Yes, I am.
Just do it.
I will do it. Cover your mouth when you cough.
Timothy, Sarah, what's with all the ruckus?
He says boys don't cry, but he isn't a boy.
Be kind. Grandma, please. He doesn't shower.
This is the song that never ends.
Your voice is a little cracky.
So
it
hurts.
No, we are not fighting today. Today is about family. Remember, we're meeting our family today.
Do not flip!
Sorry. Let's get new choice to the field, to the stage. My students will tell you I'm a control freak, so if I don't like something that they say, I'm going to say new choice, and then they have to say something else. Can I get a suggestion from the middle of a place that you'd love to go on vacation?
Hawaii!
Also the Maldives!
Yeah.
It was just like a wave of Hawaii. Suggestions. Scoot on down, new choice. Scoot on down. All right, here we go. Players, are you ready for your game of new choice?
Yes.
And begin.
So hot here. You were a fish, it wouldn't be that hot.
I'm a turtle, man.
That one was about boiling that shell. That's just.
Oh, I wish I could take it off.
New choice.
I need a wet towel.
New choice.
I want to go for a swim too.
New choice. To get you more involved. So if I could get for this next game 2 audience volunteers. Wonderful. Yeah, I'm gonna go, YMA folks, you're amazing. I'm gonna go for somebody who's joining us today. Well, I know, join Improv Court. Right there, yes, you, come on up, awesome. And then I'll take you, my friend, come on up. Let's give these folks a big round of applause. Isaac! Let's give a big hand for Isaac. No, right there, on that. Take that. That's perfect. What's your name?
Sean.
Hi, Sean. Let's give a big round of applause for Sean. Awesome. All right. So, here's how this is. Yep, pink dot right there. Perfect. Now, here's how this is going to work. This is a game called Columns. Let's get the improvisers for Columns to the stage. So, here's what's gonna happen. They're gonna do a scene, but they're gonna run out of stuff to say. And that's where you come in. They're going to prompt you, they're gonna open hand to you, and they're gonna invite you to fill in the word that they haven't quite got. So, let's practice, okay? My favorite part of breakfast this morning was...
friends.
Perfect. That's a big breakfast. All right. You know, the best part about you is really...
something that I don't think I should say.
Wow, secrets. Yeah, lots of fun. Secret, yeah, good.
Way to avoid the bad.
That was good. Okay. Ready?
Ready.
I love it. Yeah, get right up on that mic. You ready?
Ooh.
Ready? Perfect. Awesome. Okay. Players, are you ready for your game of Columns?
Yes!
But not until after I've gotten a suggestion from over here.
Yeah,
I haven't asked for anything yet. Give me something distinct to YMA. I love it. We'd like to not repeat things, but Foursquare is your suggestion. Players, are you ready for your game of Columns?
Yes.
My friends, are you ready for your game of Columns?
Kind of.
Totally.
Awesome! And begin!
Not fair, that's overhand, sir!
No, it wasn't, Bethany. I got it right over there. You see? It bounced in your square.
Yeah, but I think you should go out because...
it was deflated.
Guys, stop fighting, or we're gonna have to stop the... four square? Why is there a team of these?
Everyone
left us because they said
we're
perfect because...
we're tall.
We're tall. we're as tall as that...
elephant in the zoo.
Elephant in the room?
That's over there.
That's one mighty fine elephant.
Yeah. And you see, since we're the best, everyone left us. But in general...
Foul.
But I don't want to because I'm...
a living human being?
A living human being! I am
right.
Right,
I'm not hurting you in any way by doing this.
Well, this is a free country.
Please throw you in on my driveway. Get out.
Okay. Wait, actually, I think I left my...
Math test homework.
Well, that's not very nice. You should not say that to me.
Elephant.
So for the day, thank you so much. We got a couple of thank yous before we go. First, can we give it up to folks in the tech booth? Go ahead, put a hand in the air, turn it around, pat yourselves on the back for being such a wonderful audience. Thank you so much. Thank you for your suggestions. You're amazing. I guess there's nothing left to say, but... 1, 2, 3!
We'll say it now!
Give it up for God!
Cherry Tree, and it's basically about a cherry tree, which is the symbol for love in my song. Ace said that my song was so slay, so I hope you think it's so slay too. And a called Alternate Names for Girls Who Love to Climb Trees. 1. Girl Who Dreams of Soaring Dragons. 2. Breathless Laughs Full of Adrenaline. 3. Dark Soil with New Green Life Bursting Forth. 4. Sun-kissed with scraped knees. 5. Bleating newborn goat, still wet from birth. 6. Wide bare feet with blackened soles, ever wandering. 7. Storm-whipped Pacific waves in cold, salt-bright water. 8. A mother born from hellfire and forged into a miracle. 9. A father, steady as stone. 10. Books and books and more books. 11. Trees so tall they reach into the sky and touch the moon. 12. The feel of losing control, sharp and angry. 13. Eating cookie dough with raw eggs, but no one cares. 14. The other half of a whole. 15. Shaped by love, honed by adversity. 16. Breathless lungs filled with pain and joy. 17. An itching soul that longs to soar. 18. 18 birthdays always shared. 19. Reaching, reaching, reaching toward something untouchable.
My name is Sasha, and my poem is called Alternate Names for Someone Who Doesn't Know Where to Go. 1. New Tan by School Fluorescence. 2. Ignorer of the Californian Waves Fighting the Sun. 3. Wishes for Mom's Electric Blue Eyes. 4. Questions Answered by the Monotone Laugh Track of Disney. 5. Afraid to look in his closet. 6. Dreamer of seagulls. 7. A walking curly hair routine. 8. Allergic to the swarm of pollen which buzzes in Salem's ear. 9. So desperate to fit in, she cages her cries while giving herself injections to stop that swarm. 10. A howl of ignorance, which sounds like a safari park lion at dawn. 11. Artificial tang of palm trees. 12. Someone who can't choose who to love more. 13. Stories caught in teeth like salty popcorn. 14. Sharp smell of adolescent snow on Montana December morning. 15. Stuck in 3 different homes, but belonging in none.
I'm Pamela Dean, and this is Alternative Names for a Woman Growing into a Child. 1. Mother's Twin Soul. 2. Rain Leaking Through a Shaky Ceiling. 3. Someone's Baby Forever and Ever. 4. Always Ready to Play Mom. 5. Navy Blue Rags Draped Over Silk. 6. Salty Tears Tracing Pale Skin. 7. Daddy's Girl. 8. Tomboy. 9. God's Least Favorite Prophet. 10. Funny as in background noise. 11. Sincere as in a way I can't quite capture. 12. Hair cut off in a porcelain sink. 13. Too pretentious to have fun. 14. After all these years, still saying museum. 15. The sound of a skipping record. 16. The dry throat and pained stomach of an unacceptable 89%. 17. A whisper with the eyes of a lion. Thank you.
Hi everyone, my name is Gio, and I will be reading a poem called Alternate Names for a White Cisgender Male. 1. An eagle with fearless wings. 2. the star reaching for the moon. 3, golden sunlight on a summer evening. 4, security in busy places. 5, Portland in the winter. 6, pollen through the window. 7, the smell of orange chicken on the stove. 8, essential TV subscription. 9, healthy soda. 10, the song coming from the bathroom stall. 11, desire for something to lose. 12, whatever lunch was that day. 13, the joke that you don't understand. 14, the lightness on feet. 15, the tears that can't quite find a way out. 16, chicken strips with barbecue sauce. 17, honey and tea. 18, the smile drawn by that slam poem. 19, the cozy blanket. 20, allowed to do it. 21, walking try me sign. 22, a long good night. 23, born on the top floor. 24, the yellow bear. 25, vanilla ice cream. 26, curiosity turned to judgment. 27, the roller coaster drop.
Adieu, no glory lives behind the back of such, and then it, the fire. I will requite thee, doing my wild part to thy loving hand. If thou dost love, my kindness shall incite thee. Divine emblems of the holy bear, for others say thou dost deserve, and I believe it better than reporting.
Now before God, I'm so vexed that every part about me quivers!
Certainly, me, pray you, sir, a word. And as I told you, my unlady bade me to inquire you out what she bade me say. I will keep to myself, but first, let me tell ye that ye should leave her to a fool's paradise, as they say, for a very gross kind of behavior, as they say. For the gentlewoman is young, and therefore if you should deal low with her truly, for a very gross kind of behavior, and a very ill thing to offer any gentlewoman, and very weak dealing.
A common slave! You know him well, my son. Held up his left hand, which did flame and burn like 20 torches joined. And yet his hand, not sensible of fire, remained unscorched. Besides, I had not since put up my sword. Against the capital, I met a lion. He glared upon me and went surly by without annoying me. When these prodigies do so contrarily me, let not men say these are their reasons. They are natural, for I believe they are pretentious things.
How dare you to be friends with me than fight with mine enemy? Is he not a rude in the height, a villain? Hath slandered, scorned, dishonored my kinswoman. Oh, that I were a man! What fearful hand till they come to take hands? And then with public accusation, uncovered slander, unmitigated rancor. Oh God, that I were a man! I would eat his heart in the marketplace! But manhood is melted into courtesies, valor into compliment, and never only turned into tongue. Tribunes too. He is now as valiant as Hercules that only tells a lie and swears it. I cannot be a man with wishing, therefore I will die a woman with grieving.
The more my wrong, the more his spite appears. What? Did he marry me to banish me? Beggars I come to my father's door, upon entreaty of his aunt. If not, elsewhere they need the charity. But I, who never knew how to entreat, nor never needed that I should entreat, and starved for me, giddy for lack of sleep, with oats kept waking and with brawling fed, and that which fights me more than all these wants, he does it under name of perfect love?
Yes, what?
And in this manner, he was to imagine me his love, that has done him every day of his life.
How much time would I grieve, be a feminine, changeful, proud, fantastical, shallow, and constant, full of tears, full of smiles, for every passion something, and no passion should be anything, but now like him, now loathe, then entertain him, swear him, weep for him, then spit at him, that I drain my suitor from his bed.
For then my thoughts, from far where I abide, intend a zealous pilgrimage to thee, which keep my drooping eyelids open wide, looking upon darkness which the blind will see. Save that my soul from this imaginary sight presents my shadow on a sightless view, which, like a jewel hung in the ghastly night, makes the black night beauteous and her old face new. Lo, by day my limbs, by night my mind,
we have scotched the snake, not killed it. She'll close and be herself, whilst our poor malice remains in danger of her former tooth. But let the frame of things disjoint. Both the world suffer. There we will eat a meal in fear and sleep in affliction of these terrible dreams that shake us nightly. Better be with the dead, who we, to gain our peace, have sent to peace, but on the torch of the mind to lie in restless ecstasy. Duncan is in his grave. After life's fitful fever, he sleeps well. Nothing can touch him further.
Come, you spirits, attend on mortal thoughts. Unsex me here. Bail me from the ground to the totem pole of direst cruelty. Stop!
you a leg? No. Or an arm? No. Can honor take the grief away from a wound? No. Honor hath no skill in surgery then? No. What is honor? A word? What is that word, honor? Air. Who hath it? He that died on Wednesday, doth he feel it? No. Doth he hear it? No. Is it insensible then? Yeah. So the dead. But will it not live with the way of the living? No. Why? Depression will not suffer it, therefore I'll none of it. Honor is a mere speech, and so ends my catechism.
I will tell you why. I am of late, but wherefore I know not. Lost all my mirth, forgot all customs of exercise, and indeed it goes so heavily with my disposition that this goodly frame, the earth, seems to me a sterile promontory. This most excellent canopy, the air, look you, this brave or hanging firmament, this majestic roof fretted with golden fire, why, it appears no other thing to me than a foul, pestilent congregation of vapors. What a piece of work! Is man how noble in reason, how infinite in faculties and form and movement, how expressive, admirable, how in action like an angel, how in apprehension like a god. Yet to me, what is this quintessence of dust?
When in disgrace with fortune and men's eyes, I all alone, though weak, my outcast state, and treble deaf heaven with my mutinous cries, and look upon myself and curse my fate. Wishing me, like to one more rich in hope, feature like him with friends possessed. Desiring this man's art and that man's scope, with what I most enjoy, contented least. Yet, in these thoughts myself almost despising, haply I think of thee, and then my state, like to the lark at break of day arising, from sullen earth sings hymns at heaven's gate. For thine sweet love, remember, such wealth brings, that then I scorn to change my state with kings.
Ago. It's called Containment, and I hope you guys enjoy.
I'm not insane, it's insane inside my brain. performers were wonderful to work with. Give them one more round of applause. We thank our board of directors who are steadfast in their support of YMA, David Kinder who takes all of the photos and videotapes, and the amazing tech crew that is making all of the magic happen.
One more program that wasn't featured on stage but was featured in the art gallery is our amazing visual arts program. Let's recognize them. Two weeks, very intensive, as I'm sure you can imagine. There's a lot that goes into that on the camp side and the dorm side. I want to acknowledge our incredible counselors who are with them 24/7, waking them up, making sure their rooms are clean. Working with them very intensely every day, challenging them as much as they can challenge them while still being incredibly kind and nurturing. All of you will see the amazing artistic progress that your students have made. Congratulations to our faculty.
A few quick things. If you will all join us over for the final gathering at the flagpole. Parents and campers and everybody, please join us over there. We hope you had a wonderful time here. We will miss you all, and please drive safely.